In the last few years, we've seen a staggering increase in media consumption on the web, while worldwide internet bandwidth has not kept the same pace. To help with this, my name is Vignesh. I'm here to talk about how you can take advantage of a new video format for the web. Video already accounts for more than half of the peak internet bandwidth worldwide and almost two-thirds of the peak internet bandwidth in certain parts of the world. The WebM project is a collection of open tools and media technologies that aim to tackle the challenges of media at internet scale and enable open and free communication of ideas through media. The WebM project develops two video codecs, VP8 and VP9, a media container, that's the WebM container, and an image format called WebP. These technologies together power some of your favorite Google services at a large scale, like YouTube and Hangouts. They are also widely used on the web. For example, Netflix and Facebook use WebP. We announced VP9, our next generation open video codec, at I/O 2013. Videos encoded in VP9 see up to 50% improvement in compression efficiency. Today, VP9 video playback is supported in Chrome, Firefox, Opera, and Android. Since I/O 2013, we've improved both the speed and the compression efficiency of VP9. This has enabled YouTube to choose VP9 as their next generation video codec. If you're curious about updates to VP9 since I/O 2013, check out our video updates to VP9. Additionally, if you want to deep dive into the encoding techniques used to achieve the compression performance, we highly recommend checking out our I/O 2013 session on VP9. It's called the new open video codec. In this video, I'm going to focus on how to easily encode VP9 videos using open source tools, and then go on to talk about how we can play those videos back. First, the simple progressive encode. Let's say that you just want to encode a video and want it to be played back across multiple devices. In other words, all you want to do is just host a video and play it back using the video tag by using the hosted URL as the source. Here's how you do it. Progressive encodes are simple and will allow any supported VP9 player to download and play the file. Examples include Chrome, Firefox, and Android. Here is how you create a progressive VP9 encode. All you need to do is point FFmpeg to your input file and ask it to use the VP9 encoder. Here's how you play back this video. That was simple, wasn't it? If you have ideas on making it even simpler, we welcome all your thoughts at this email. Okay, now, if you plan to serve video over the web, chances are that you want to take advantage of some of the HTML5 technologies that will allow you to provide a great streaming experience to your customers. This has traditionally been tough, and an industry standard was born to solve this, called Dash. Dash stands for Dynamic Adaptive Streaming over HTTP, and it allows you to select the stream that will provide the best perceived quality depending on the client's constraints. Traditionally, this is bundled with the term adaptive playback. At Google, we use adaptive playback using Dash and HTML5 technologies like media source extensions to provide a great streaming experience on YouTube. For example, with VP9 and Dash, we've improved the key metrics of streaming videos, rebuffers. VP9 Dash videos have improved rebuffers by 25% in developed markets and up to 50% in emerging markets. Okay, we've heard from video developers that creating a Dash manifest for VP9 has been challenging. I'm happy to announce that we've worked with FFmpeg and are announcing a set of open source tools to simplify the encoding process. Let's now take a look at how to encode VP9 Dash videos and generate the manifest. Encoding a VP9 video to be compatible with Dash is very similar to doing a progressive encode with a few minor changes. For Dash, the video and audio has to be encoded separately into two different files. You also need to pass the extra Dash parameter to FFmpeg so that it creates WebM files which are Dash compliant. Now that you have the video and the audio files encoded, you can make use of the WebM Dash Manifest tool to generate the Dash Manifest file. The WebM Dash Manifest tool is part of the WebM Tools project. You can download the tools we used to create Dash streams and the manifest from the links found on this slide. Okay, let's now talk about integrating a video player to playback VP9 videos using Dash. Just to reiterate, VP9 decoding support is already available in Chrome, Firefox, Opera, and Android. Together, they represent over a billion devices and browsers that can playback VP9 video. But creating a VP9 player to playback adaptive video is a little more difficult, although there are two players that makes it easy. To put together, they enable adaptive VP9 playback on two of the most popular platforms, the web and Android. First off, Android. YouTube open sourced a player called the ExoPlayer that supports adaptive playback of VP9. To know more about how to use ExoPlayer to enable VP9 Dash videos in your app, see the talk by YouTube on ExoPlayer. For the web, we added VP9 Dash support to Dash.js, which is a fantastic all-in-one media player built entirely in HTML5. For more information on how to use Dash.js to playback adaptive VP9 videos, you can follow the link on this slide. With these tools, encoding and decoding VP9 content has never been easier. Now it's your job to tell a great story or ship the next great video player. And of course, we're here to help. Drop us a line at webm-discus@webmproject.org. Thank you.